Namaste. Hello, everybody. I want to know today, why is our Pradhan Mantri quiet? Why is Amit Shah quiet? Why is Yogi Adityanath quiet? As you all know, that 33 farmers have lost their lives, and today is their Shraddhanjali. Why is the Pradhan Mantri quiet? Why not a single word to these farmers and their families by the Pradhan Mantri? Where is the Home Minister? Nobody is consoling the families of these farmers who are at the border. You know that this is the coldest winter and they are there. Amit Shah, the Home Minister, can go to Bengal, but he cannot just go to this border, which is around 5 kilometers, and console the family. These are our annadatas who give us food. Have we forgotten them? The callousness of this government is on full display when on one hand, lakhs of farmers are asking for justice. And on the other side, you have the most gruesome gang rape and cover-up witnessed in the 73-year history of India. And here, the most important is the cover-up of this gang rape in Hathras. Cover-up, complicity and collusion of the Yogi Adityanath government stands exposed. Yogi Adityanath, alias Ajay Singh Bisht, and his government now stand exposed before the people of this country by filing of the charge sheet by the CBI on the gruesome Hathras rape and murder which shook the soul of this nation. The systematic and diabolic design by which a national campaign was launched by the Modi government, the Yogi Adityanath government and the BJP, along with a section of the media, for discrediting and tarnishing the character of the hapless Hathras gang rape victim, questioning the motive of the family, questioning the financial capacity of the family, and repeatedly attempting to convert it into a caste dispute or honor killing, now lay in tatters. Never before in the 73-year history of India, a brutal gang rape victim had to face all this. Innuendos and insinuations against her, her family's image tarnished. They were subjected to harassment, they were threatened, and they were even detained. Even the members of the press who are sitting here, were you allowed to meet them? They were locked up in their own home. Now I'm going to give you certain facts of this case, which of course you already know, but since there's been a cover-up here, since this government is accountable, the Yogi Adityanath government is fully accountable for this cover-up. The FIR took 8 days to register, that too after her family ran from pillar to post. Despite her dying declaration on September 22nd in the presence of the district magistrate, where she stated that she was gang raped, the Hathras SP kept insisting that there was no evidence of sexual assault. Now, this is a very important point here. Why? Because in the Nirbhaya case, finally, the conviction and hanging of the rapist happened based on that dying declaration of Nirbhaya. So when there was a statement given to her in front of the magistrate, that should have been taken by the Yogi Adityanath government, the police, and the conviction should have started the investigation and saying that, you know, she's gang raped. That is what the government should do, support the victim. But here the police officer comes out and says that there is no evidence of rape after the statement in front of the magistrate. UP additional DG of police Law and Order Prashant Kumar, citing some reports which spoke about absence of semen on victim's body, thereby kept distracting the investigation, saying that the victim was not raped. Now look at here, who is saying this? The DG Law and Order. It's unfathomable that he does not know that there is no requirement of the presence of semen to say it's a rape. The Nirbhaya Act of 2013 says clearly that the legal requirement to determine rape does not mean that there has to be a semen there. So again, this was obviously an attempt to mislead the evidence and protect the rapists. Who gave the orders to the police to forcefully cremate this little girl on that night at 3 a.m.? Who gave? Do you think the police will just go out and do it at 3 a.m.? They know that it's against the Hindu custom. And you have a BJP government who speaks about pious Hinduism. How did they do that? Who gave them the go-ahead? The district magistrate. Now, who gave the go-ahead to the district magistrate is the question. And we all know who the police comes under. The police comes under the Home Minister. And who's the Home Minister? Yogi Adityanath. BJP MLAs and MPs, including Shri Mohan Madhvi, Shri Surendra Singh, openly defended the rapists. The BJP IT cell head even published the victim's face, if you all remember. The BJP IT cell head published the face, which according to section 228A is punishable by imprisonment of 2 years. Shouldn't he be behind bars now? Why should he get away? This is a crime. When there is an ongoing investigation, when there is one side saying that she has given her dying declaration that she was gang raped, and the administration, UP administration, saying it was not a gang rape, but there was an investigation, how dare the IT cell head publishes a face? That means there is a go-ahead from the top. Why has Mr. Modi not taken any action on this IT cell head? I want to know that. See, as long as action is not taken, they can do whatever they want. Let's be clear on that. However, the person whose behavior has been the most bizarre and reprehensible is the UP CM Ajay Singh Bisht. Because he's not only the CM, he's also the Home Minister of UP. The forceful cremation of the victim instructed by the DM of Hathras and the successive attempt to cover up the act could not have happened without his permission. When cornered by intense public scrutiny and media inquiry, what did Mr. Yogi Adityanath do? He hired a PR firm. And he said, this is a conspiracy, international conspiracy to defame his government. He hired the PR firm which said that, you know what, there has been no rape. Now, if he really wanted justice for this rape victim, if he really wanted justice for India's daughter, he would have stood with the family. He would have not hired the PR firm. He would have not said it's an international conspiracy. He would have said that, you know what, I will see to it that this girl gets justice. The administration tried everything to hush up the case. But why did it go? Why did CBI take over it? Because due to the sheer persistence of Rahul Gandhi ji and Priyanka Gandhi ji and the rest of the opposition, who were repeatedly stopped from going to Hathras. Rahul Gandhi ji and Priyanka Gandhi ji even had to face police brutality to get justice for this girl. Remember that. And on their way to reach the victim's family, they were harassed. They wanted to listen to their concern of the family. And this, when they went, spoke, they were persistent. After that, the UP government reluctantly gave it to the CPI. Let me put it very clear, reluctantly. We demand that the accountability must be fixed. UP police, who are responsible for the botch-up, should be punished for this willful subversion of justice. The UP government has used its full might of the state to deny justice to the victim. UP CM Shri Yogi Adityanath, alias Shri Ajay Singh Bisht, should take moral responsibility and resign from his post because he has no moral authority to be in this post. The Congress Party and the people of India will not rest until Ajay Singh Bisht resigns and is held accountable for this shameful act, for the shameful cover-up of the rape, of this gang rape and murder of this Hathras victim. Thank you very much. आज 33 farmers आप लोगों को पता है देहांत हो गए हैं और अभी भी मोदी जी उनको उनके जो परिवार है उनको मिलने के लिए गए नहीं उनको कंसोल करने के लिए गए नहीं अमित शाह जी भी नहीं गए सब यहाँ हैं अमित शाह जी जा सकते हैं बंगाल प्रचार करने के लिए जिसका चुनाव है मई में लेकिन वो वहाँ हैं और जो हमारे जो अन्नदाता बॉर्डर पे है जो 5-10 किलोमीटर यहाँ से है उनके पास नहीं जाते हैं उनके परिवार को कंसोल करने के लिए नहीं जाते हैं ये क्या न्याय है वो हमारे जो किसान लोग न्याय के लिए मांग रहे हैं और यहाँ अन्याय हो रहा है इस सरकार से और जब भी कुछ प्रश्न पूछे मोदी जी से अमित शाह जी से सब मौन है आज भी एक शब्द नहीं आया उनके मुंह से कि हाँ हमारे जो अन्नदाता के देहांत हो गए हैं कुछ भी नहीं सीबीआई के चार्जशीट फाइल करने के बाद हाथरस बलात्कार और हत्याकांड में आदित्यनाथ सरकार की भूमिका के रहस्यों से पर्दा उठ गया है सरकार ने जांच को भटकाने की कोशिश की आरोपियों को बचाने की कोशिश की और पीड़िता के परिवारों को न्याय से वंचित रखा पिछले 73 वर्षों के आजाद भारत के इतिहास में यह पहली दफा हुआ कि पीड़िता को उसकी मृत्यु के बाद भी बदनाम किया गया उनके चरित्र पर प्रश्न उठाया गया पीड़िता के परिवार वालों को बदनाम किया गया धमकाया गया इस घटना को जाति हिंसा बताया गया यहां तक कि प्रेस के मित्रों को भी पीड़िता के परिवार से मिलने से रोका गया और पूरी सरकार प्रशासन भाजपा पार्टी भाजपा नेता सब ने मिलकर इस दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण घटना को पर्दा डालने की कोशिश की जांच को भटकाने की कोशिश की आज जब सत्य सबके सामने है हम कांग्रेस पार्टी के मन से ये मांग करते हैं कि घटना की जिम्मेवारी तय हो और दोषियों को कड़ी से कड़ी सजा मिले पुलिस प्रशासन के अधिकारी जो आरोपी हो उन्हें तत्काल निलंबित किया जाए एवं उनके खिलाफ जांच बिठाई जाए मुख्यमंत्री आदित्यनाथ को तुरंत नैतिक जिम्मेवारी लेते हुए अपने पद से इस्तीफा देना चाहिए प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी और भाजपा नेताओं को देश से माफी मांगनी चाहिए See, what I would like to say on that is, it's a good thing always to go to a Gurudwara, go to a Mandir. You know, we are all very spiritual people, Indians, and I appreciate the Prime Minister going there. But what I would like to say is that, you know, there are these farmers who are there protesting out at the border. 33 of them have died due to this extreme cold. You all know it's very cold. Even sitting inside the house, we need heaters. Now, they are on the roads out there. He can just go there and console them. Where is empathy? They say that Pradhan Mantri is a man who loves this country, who loves his people. He keeps saying that, you know, each one of you are inside me. Where is the empathy from the Pradhan Mantri? He could just go and say, visit them and just console the family. Just imagine what is going through those families, the children. They're also there at the borders. I have visited them personally over there. And I can tell you it's very cold. It's very difficult. So I would urge the Pradhan Mantri to go out there and visit them instead of just, you know, going to religious places, which we understand is a good thing, but he must go and visit them and console them and listen to them, give justice to these farmers and repel these black laws and get new laws done, reenact them. ऐसे उसमें कुछ क्या है, ऑपोजिशन पार्टीज विपक्ष लोग तो बात कर सकते हैं ना, ये तो अभी भी एक डेमोक्रेसी है ना हिंदुस्तान। आप क्या बोल रहे हो कि ये डेमोक्रेसी नहीं है? यहाँ डेमोक्रेसी है ना, हाँ, तो उसमें हम बातचीत कर सकते हैं, कोई भी किसी के साथ बातचीत कर सकते हैं, आप मेरे साथ बातचीत कर सकते हैं, इसमें क्या है? जयराम जी ने वहाँ स्पष्ट किया है, क्लियरली बताया कि उनका जो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंसेस था उन्होंने कहा है ये, तो उन्होंने माफी मांग ली, खत्म हो गया उसमें से, तो उसके ऊपर क्या बातचीत है?
तो
मैं समझ गई आप क्या पूछ रहे हो, तो लेकिन उन्होंने माफी मांग ली, मेरे हिसाब से उससे खत्म हो गया है मैटर। मैं कहना चाहती हूँ कि उन्होंने वो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस किया है, ठीक है, वो एक वरिष्ठ नेता है और उन्होंने माफी मांग ली, उससे बात खत्म हो गया है। एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस? थैंक यू, नमस्ते। वांट टू डू अ डिब्रीफ? ओके, बाय। Is it too high? I feel it was very high. Can we now remove this? Perfect. Okay, because I'm very far. My paper is here. You feel it? आपके लिए ठीक है ना? मेरे लिए थोड़ा ऊपर लग रहा है। Because my papers, yeah.
That will give you a clue. I will first learn to. Hello.
Namaste. Hello, everybody. I want to know today, why is our Pradhan Mantri quiet? Why is Amit Shah quiet? Why is Yogi Adityanath quiet? As you all know, that 33 farmers have lost their lives, and today is their Shraddhanjali. Why is the Pradhan Mantri quiet? Why not a single word to these farmers and their families by the Pradhan Mantri? Where is the Home Minister? Nobody is consoling the families of these farmers who are at the border. You know that this is the coldest winter and they are there. Amit Shah, the Home Minister, can go to Bengal, but he cannot just go to this border, which is around 5 kilometers, and console the family? These are our annadatas who give us food. Have we forgotten them? The callousness of this government is on full display when on one hand, lakhs of farmers are asking for justice. And on the other side, you have the most gruesome gang rape and cover-up witnessed in the 73-year history of India. And here, the most important is the cover-up of this gang rape in Hathras. Cover-up, complicity and collusion of the Yogi Adityanath government stands exposed. Yogi Adityanath, alias Ajay Singh Bisht, and his government now stand exposed before the people of this country by filing of the charge sheet by the CBI on the gruesome Hathras rape and murder which shook the soul of this nation. The systematic and diabolic design by which a national campaign was launched by the Modi government, the Yogi Adityanath government and the BJP, along with a section of the media, for discrediting and tarnishing the character of the hapless Hathras gang rape victim, questioning the motive of the family, questioning the financial capacity of the family, and repeatedly attempting to convert it into a caste dispute or honor killing, now lay in tatters. Never before in the 73-year history of India, a brutal gang rape victim had to face all this. Innuendos and insinuations against her, her family's image tarnished. They were subjected to harassment, they were threatened, and they were even detained. Even the members of the press who are sitting here, were you allowed to meet them? They were locked up in their own home. Now I'm going to give you certain facts of this case, which of course you already know, but since there's been a cover-up here, since this government is accountable, the Yogi Adityanath government is fully accountable for this cover-up. The FIR took 8 days to register, that too after her family ran from pillar to post. Despite her dying declaration on September 22nd in the presence of the district magistrate, where she stated that she was gang raped, the Hathras SP kept insisting that there was no evidence of sexual assault. Now, this is a very important point here. Why? Because in the Nirbhaya case, finally the conviction and hanging of the rapist happened based on that dying declaration of Nirbhaya. So when she has done, she has given up this, there was a statement given to her in front of the magistrate that should have been taken by the Yogi Adityanath government, the police, and the conviction should have started the investigation and saying that, you know, she's gang raped. That is what the government should do, support the victim. But here the police officer comes out and says that there is no evidence of rape after the statement in front of the magistrate. UP Additional DG of Police Law and Order Prashant Kumar, citing some reports which spoke about absence of semen on victim's body, thereby kept distracting the investigation, saying that the victim was not raped. Now look at here, who is saying this? The DG Law and Order. It's unfathomable that he does not know that there is no requirement of the presence of semen to say it's a rape. The Nirbhaya Act of 2013 says clearly that there is no legal, the legal requirement to determine rape does not mean that there has to be a semen there. So again, this was obviously an attempt to mislead the evidence and protect the rapists. Who gave the orders to the police to forcefully cremate this little girl on that night at 3 a.m.? Who gave? Do you think the police will just go out and do it at 3 a.m.? They know that it's against the Hindu custom. And you have a BJP government who speaks about pious Hinduism. How did they do that? Who gave them the go-ahead? The district magistrate. Now, who gave the go-ahead to the district magistrate is the question. And we all know who the police comes under. The police comes under the Home Minister. And who's the Home Minister? Yogi Adityanath. BJP MLAs and MPs, including Shri Mohan Madhvi, Shri Surendra Singh, openly defended the rapists. The BJP IT cell head even published the victim's face, if you all remember. The BJP IT cell head published the face, which according to section 228A is punishable by imprisonment of 2 years. Shouldn't he be behind bars now? Why should he get away? This is a crime. When there is an ongoing investigation, when there is one side saying that she has given her dying declaration that she was gang raped, and the administration, UP administration, saying it was not a gang rape but there was an investigation, how dare the IT cell head publishes a face? That means there is a go-ahead from the top. Why has Mr. Modi not taken any action on this IT cell head? I want to know that. See, as long as action is not taken, they can do whatever they want. Let's be clear on that. However, the person whose behavior has been the most bizarre and reprehensible is the UP CM Ajay Singh Bisht. Because he's not only the CM, he's also the Home Minister of UP. The forceful cremation of the victim instructed by the DM of Hathras and the successive attempt to cover up the act could not have happened without his permission. When cornered by intense public scrutiny and media inquiry, what did Mr. Yogi Adityanath do? He hired a PR firm and he said this is a conspiracy, international conspiracy to defame his government. He hired the PR firm which said that, you know what, there has been no rape. Now, if he really wanted justice for this rape victim, if he really wanted justice for India's daughter, he would have stood with the family. He would have not hired the PR firm. He would have not said it's an international conspiracy. He would have said that, you know what, I will see to it that this girl gets justice. The administration tried everything to hush up the case. But why did it go? Why did CBI take over it? Because due to the sheer persistence of Rahul Gandhi ji and Priyanka Gandhi ji and the rest of the opposition, who were repeatedly stopped from going to Hathras. Rahul Gandhi ji and Priyanka Gandhi ji even had to face police brutality to get justice for this girl. Remember that. And on their way to reach the victim's family, they were harassed. They wanted to listen to their concern of the family. And this, when they went, spoke, they were persistent. After that, the UP government reluctantly gave it to the CPI. Let me put it very clear, reluctantly. We demand that the accountability must be fixed. UP police, who are responsible for the botch-up, should be punished for this willful subversion of justice. The UP government has used its full might of the state to deny justice to the victim. UP CM Shri Yogi Adityanath, alias Shri Ajay Singh Bisht, should take moral responsibility and resign from his post because he has no moral authority to be in this post. The Congress Party and the people of India will not rest until Ajay Singh Bisht resigns and is held accountable for this shameful act, for the shameful cover-up of the rape, of this gang rape and murder of this Hathras victim. Thank you very much. आज 33 फार्मर्स आप लोग को पता है देहांत हो गए हैं और अभी भी मोदी जी उनको उनके जो परिवार है उनको मिलने के लिए गए नहीं उनको कंसोल करने के लिए गए नहीं अमित शाह जी भी नहीं गए सब यहाँ हैं अमित शाह जी जा सकते हैं बंगाल प्रचार करने के लिए जिसका चुनाव है मई में, लेकिन वो वहां है। और जो हमारे जो अन्नदाता बॉर्डर पे है, जो 5-10 किलोमीटर यहां से है, उनके पास नहीं जाते हैं, उनके परिवार को कंसोल करने के लिए नहीं जाते हैं। ये क्या न्याय है? वो हमारे जो किसान लोग न्याय के लिए मांग रहे हैं और यहां अन्याय हो रहा है इस सरकार से। और जब भी कुछ प्रश्न पूछे मोदी जी से, अमित शाह जी से, सब मौन है। आज भी एक शब्द नहीं आया उनके मुंह से कि हाँ, हमारे जो अन्नदाता के देहांत हो गए हैं, कुछ भी नहीं। सीबीआई के चार्जशीट फाइल करने के बाद हाथरस बलात्कार और हत्याकांड में आदित्यनाथ सरकार की भूमिका के रहस्यों से पर्दा उठ गया है। सरकार ने जांच को भटकाने की कोशिश की, आरोपियों को बचाने की कोशिश की और पीड़िता के परिवारों को न्याय से वंचित रखा। पिछले 73 वर्षों के आजाद भारत के इतिहास में यह पहली दफा हुआ है कि पीड़िता को उसके मृत्यु के बाद भी बदनाम किया गया, उनके चरित्र पर प्रश्न उठाया गया। पीड़िता के परिवार वालों को बदनाम किया गया, धमकाया गया। इस घटना को जाति हिंसा बताया गया। यहां तक कि प्रेस के मित्रों को भी पीड़िता के परिवार से मिलने से रोका गया और पूरी सरकार, प्रशासन, भाजपा पार्टी, भाजपा नेता सब ने मिलकर इस दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण घटना को पर्दा डालने की कोशिश की, जांच को भटकाने की कोशिश की। आज जब सत्य सबके सामने है, हम कांग्रेस पार्टी के मन से ये मांग करते हैं कि घटना की जिम्मेवारी तय हो और दोषियों को कड़ी से कड़ी सजा मिले। पुलिस प्रशासन के अधिकारी जो आरोपी हो, उन्हें तत्काल निलंबित किया जाए एवं उनके खिलाफ जांच बिठाई जाए। मुख्यमंत्री आदित्यनाथ को तुरंत नैतिक जिम्मेवारी लेते हुए अपने पद से इस्तीफा देना चाहिए। प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी और भाजपा नेताओं को देश से माफी मांगनी चाहिए। See, what I would like to say on that is, it's a good thing always to go to a gurudwara, go to a mandir. You know, we are all very spiritual people, Indians, and I appreciate the Prime Minister going there. But what I would like to say is that, you know, there are these farmers who are there protesting out at the border. 33 of them have died due to this extreme cold. You all know it's very cold. Even sitting inside the house, we need heaters. Now, they are on the roads out there. He can just go there and console them. Where is empathy? They say that Pradhan Mantri is a man who loves this country, who loves his people. He keeps saying that, you know, each one of you are inside me. Where is the empathy from the Pradhan Mantri? He could just go and say, visit them and just console the family. Just imagine what is going through those families, the children. They're also there at the borders. I have visited them personally over there. And I can tell you it's very cold. It's very difficult. So I would urge the Pradhan Mantri to go out there and visit them instead of just, you know, going to religious places, which we understand is a good thing, but he must go and visit them and console them and listen to them, give justice to these farmers and repel these black laws and get new laws done, reenact them. ऐसे उसमें कुछ क्या है, ऑपोजिशन पार्टीज, विपक्ष लोग तो बात कर सकते हैं ना। ये तो अभी भी एक डेमोक्रेसी है ना हिंदुस्तान। आप क्या बोल रहे हो कि ये डेमोक्रेसी नहीं है? यहाँ डेमोक्रेसी है ना। हाँ, तो उसमें हम बातचीत कर सकते हैं, कोई भी किसी के साथ बातचीत कर सकते हैं, आप मेरे साथ बातचीत कर सकते हैं, इसमें क्या है?
आर्टिकल के हवाले से आरोप लगाया था अरविंद डोवाल के बेटे पे, तो जयराम रमेश ने तो माफी मांगी है, क्या कांग्रेस भी माफी मांगेगी, क्या कांग्रेस की क्या प्रतिक्रिया है जयराम रमेश ने जो माफी मांगी है?
सी जयराम जी ने वहां स्पष्ट किया है, क्लियरली बताया कि उनका जो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंसेस था उन्हें उन्होंने कहा है ये, तो उन्होंने माफी मांग ली, खत्म हो गया उसमें से, तो उसके ऊपर क्या बातचीत है?
तो
मैं समझ गई आप क्या पूछ रहे हो, तो लेकिन उन्होंने माफी मांग ली, मेरे हिसाब से उससे खत्म हो गया है मैटर। मैं कहना चाहती हूं कि उन्होंने वो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस किया है, ठीक है, वो एक वरिष्ठ नेता है और उन्होंने माफी मांग ली, उससे बात खत्म हो गया है। एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस? थैंक यू, नमस्ते। आई वांट टू डू अ डिब्रीफ, ओके।